Hello students, this is Nilanjana Sanyal from My Math Friend Online and eParashana. Today in this session we will be knowing how to solve simultaneous linear equations. There are several methods of solving simultaneous linear equations. Today in this session we will be learning about the substitution method. We will be knowing about the other methods in our coming sessions. So, first of all, let us take up a sum. This is our given sum. We have two linear equations involving the same two variables x and y. We know that if we have to find unique values of two variables, we should be having at least two equations. And we have been provided with two linear equations, x plus 4y equal to 14 and 7x minus 3y equal to 5. Now let us see how does this substitution method work. It says that step number 1 is we number the two given equations as equation 1 and equation 2. So these two are the two given equations, so let us number them as equation 1 and equation 2. This is equation 1. And this one is equation 2. Okay. So we have numbered these two equations. And now we come to step number 2. It says that we find the value of one of the two variables in terms of the other variable from one of the two given equations and number that equation as equation number 3. So we have to select one of these two equations. Let us take this first equation, x plus 4y equal to 14. So first of all, let us write this equation again. X plus 4y equal to 14. Next, what do we have to do? We find the value of one of the two variables in terms of the other variable. So we have selected this equation 1. Next, we have to find the value of x in terms of y, or we can find the value of y in terms of x. I'll be showing you both the expressions. Actually, you have to do only one. So x plus 4y equal to 14. If we want to find the value of x in terms of y, what we do? We will be keeping x to the left hand side of the equal to sign and we take the other term to the right hand side. That is by transposition. So the plus 4y will be equal to minus 4y. The sign will get changed. So we have x equal to 14 minus 4y. Okay, so we have expressed the variable x in terms of y. We have found the value of x in terms of y. Next, let us find the value of y in terms of x from this very first equation. It is, the first equation is x plus 4y equal to 14. Next, we'll be requiring one more line. So, next what we do? We keep the y term to the left hand side of the equal to sign and we take x to the other side. So, the plus x will get converted to minus x by transposition method. We have used this transposition method over here. Let us solve this by some other method. We would like to eliminate x from this side. How do we eliminate? If we add a negative x to both sides, whatever we do to the left hand side, we have to do the same thing to the right hand side of the equal to sign. So we add a negative x to both the sides. That means x plus 4y minus x equal to 14 minus x. So these two will get cancelled. and we have a single term 4y in the left hand side. We can do it by this method also. Next, what do? We have 4y in the left hand side. It is 4y equal to 14 minus 6. Now, we would like to have only this y term, only this y, not this coefficient of 4. Y with a coefficient of 1. So, how do we change the coefficient of y to 1? By dividing both the sides by 4. So, 4y divided by 4 equal to 14 minus x by 4, which gives us y equal to 14 minus x by 4. So we see that we are having the y in terms of x in a fractional form. Okay? See, over here we are having this form of x, x equal to 14 minus 4y. But for y in terms of x, we are having y equal to 14 minus x by 4 divided by 4, which is a fraction. So, obviously, we would like to avoid fractional form. So, we will be choosing this equation, x equal to 14 minus 4y, and we will be numbering it as equation number 3. So, just remember this, whenever you are having an equation which contains one of its variable, which contains the coefficient of one of its variable as 1. Over here, x is having a coefficient of 1. So, if you have one of the two equations in which the coefficient of one of the variables is equal to 1, then select that equation. That is why I have taken up this first equation, x plus 4y equal to 14. Select that equation and express the variable which has a coefficient of 1 in terms of the other variable. That is the thing that we have done over here. X is having a coefficient of 1, so we have expressed this x in terms of y. Okay. See, if we had taken equation number 2, the coefficient of x is 7 and the coefficient of y is minus 3. So, if we would have expressed x in terms of y, we would have got a fractional form. Same would have been the case for y. So, since it will not be this case, means you will not be having a coefficient of 1 for one of the variables in one of the two equations provided every time. But if you have such a case, then always go for that. Okay? Next, we have expressed x in terms of y and we have numbered this equation as equation number 3. Now, what does step 3 says? Step 3 says that we substitute. See, I have highlighted this word substitute because from here comes the name of the method, substitution method. Okay, we substitute this value of the variable, that is in our case x, from equation 3 in the other equation. Now, which one is the other equation? Since equation 3 has been obtained from equation 1, the other equation is equation 2. Okay? So, the values, we substitute this value of the variable from equation 3 in the other equation to get the numerical value of the second variable. The second variable is obviously y in our case. Okay? So, we will be taking up the other equation, that is equation number 2. Let us write the equation number 2 once more. 7x minus 3y equal to 5. Now we will be substituting this value of x over here in equation number 2. This is equation number 2. So this is equal to 7 times, in place of x we write 14 minus 4y from equation 3. 14 minus 4y minus 3y equal to 5. Okay. And next we open the brackets. 7 times 14 is 98. So we have 98 minus 7 times 4 gives us 28. 28y minus 3y equal to 5. Next, this implies, next, this is a simple equation containing a single variable y, so we know how to get the value of y from a simple equation. So we'll be keeping the factors of y or the terms containing y to this side of the equal to sign, that is the left hand side of the equal to sign, and we'll be taking this constant term to the right hand side of the equal to sign. So the sign of 98 will get changed. It is a plus 98, it will be change to a minus 98 when we change the side. So this is minus 28y minus 3y equal to 5 minus 98. And minus 28y minus 3y is, because both are having minus signs, the signs are the same, we will be adding the two terms and we will be putting the common sign in front. So it is minus 31y equal to 5 minus 98 is minus 93. Okay. So this is equal to, when we multiply both the sides, we see both are negatives. So we would like to make them positive. How do we make them positive numbers? By multiplying both the terms by a minus 1. So if we multiply both the sides of the equal to sign by a minus 1, we'll be getting positive numbers. So minus 1 times minus 31y equal to minus 1 times minus 93, which gives us 31y equal to 93. And this is equal to, again, if we divide both the sides by 31, because we would like to have the value of y, not 31y. So we are dividing both the sides by the number 31. Okay. And these two will get cancelled, and 31 1, and this is 31 times 3 is 93. So we have got the value of y as 3. We have got the numerical value of y as 3. Okay. This is the numerical value of y. Next we come to, so we have got the numerical value of the second variable. We have come to the end of step 3. Now coming to step 4. We substitute the numerical value of the second variable, that is y equal to 3, in equation 3 to get the numerical value of the first variable, that is numerical value of x. So we will be substituting this value of y as y equal to 3 in this equation 3. So we again write this equation 3. X equal to 14 minus 4y. Next, we will be substituting the value of y in this equation. That is 14 minus 4 into 3, or 4 times 3. This is x equal to 4 times 3 is 12. So, it is 14 minus 12. Gives us x equal to 2. So we have found the numerical values of x and y. X equal to 2 and y equal to 3. Okay, so let us write the answer. It is x equal to 2 and y equal to 3. This is our answer. Okay. This is our answer. Now, let us come to the checking part. Let us see whether we have obtained the correct result or not. How do we check that? We'll be substituting the value of x and y in the two given equations. Okay, and see whether the given value or the obtained value of x and y satisfy the two given equations or not. Okay, so the first equation is x plus 4y equal to 14. First of all, let us take up that equation. X plus 4y equal to 14. X plus 4y equal to 14. Now let us put the values of x and y. X equal to 2, so we write 2 over here, plus 4 times y equal to 3. So it is, we have got y equal to 3, and the right hand side is a 14. So 2 plus 12 equal to 14. The left hand side, if we add these two terms, 2 plus 12, we get a 14. So the left hand side is equal to the right hand side. So the value of x as 2 and y as 3 satisfies the equation number 1, that is x plus 4y equal to 14. Now let us take up the equation number 2. We can see the equation number 2 is this, 7x minus 3y equal to 5. So let us take up that equation. 7x minus 3y equal to 5. This is 7 times 7 into 2 minus 3 times 3 equal to 5. 7 times 2 is 14 minus 3 times 3 is 9 equal to 5. And 14 minus 9 is a 5. So it is 5 equal to 5. So we see even in this case, the value of x equal to 2 and y equal to 3 satisfies this equation number 2, that is 7x minus 3y equal to 5. So our answer is correct. X equal to 2 and y equal to 3. Therefore, we call these two equations as simultaneous equations, because this set of values x equal to 2 and y equal to 3 simultaneously satisfies both the two given equations. Okay, so we have learned about the substitution method. A quick recapitulation. Let us do a quick recapitulation. First of all, we number the two given equations as equation 1 and equation 2. We have numbered them as 1 and 2. Next step number 2 says that we find the value of one of the two variables in terms of the other variable. First of all, from one of the two given equations. So this has to be selected first. We select the first equation. Now we know why do we select the first equation, because we see that the coefficient of x is 1 in this case. So we are selecting this first equation and we are expressing the value of x in terms of y, because if we express the value of y in terms of x, we get a fractional form, which is not at all desirable. Okay, so of course, if we cannot have any other choice, if we do not have any other choice, then we have to accept it. But since we are having this choice, we are taking this one. We are sticking to this part, x equal to 14 minus 4y. Next, what do? We come to the third part, it is x equal to 14 minus 4y. And first of all, we number this equation as equation number 3. Next, we come to step number 3. We substitute this value of the variable from equation 3 in the other equation, because equation 3 has been obtained from equation 1. The other equation becomes equation 2. Now we will be substituting this value of x in equation number 2 to get the numerical value of the second variable, which in our case is 1. Okay, so first of all, we write this equation 2. It is 7x minus 3y equal to 5, and we substitute this value of x from equation 3. We write 14 minus 4y in place of x, and we open the bracket, do the simplification, and find the numerical value of y, which we have obtained as y equal to 3. Now step 4 says that we substitute the numerical value of the second variable, which in our case is y. We have obtained the value of y equal to 3 and in equation 3 to get the numerical value of the first variable, that is x. So we take up this equation x equal to 14 minus 4y, and in place of y we are writing this numerical value of y. So it becomes x equal to 14 minus 4 times 3, which is equal to 12. So x equal to 14 minus 12, which gives us a value of 2 for x. And so we arrive at the answer as x equal to 2 and y equal to 3. And we have checked the two equations, and we have seen that x equal to 2 and y equal to 3 simultaneously satisfies both the given two equations. Okay. Thank you for hearing.